Hello everyone, welcome back to Muse Mangalore. Today we are going to have a small trip to Shahpur. Shahpur is a place in Maharashtra state. It's around 50-60 kilometers from Mumbai city. Shahpur has some scenic places like Tansa Dam, Tansa Lake, Manas Mandir and Jambe Dam. So that's the itinerary for today. The weather is pleasant today and we hope we will get great visuals and I think we will be able to enjoy. Let's go for the trip. So friends, we are starting from Kalyan and we will be touching Nashik Road, and from thereafter we will be proceeding on Nashik Road. So as we go along, we can see the sights, the scenery together. And you can see I have two YouTubers, fellow YouTubers with me. They manage the channel called SWAT Kids. It's a wonderful channel. If you have time, please do watch the same as well. And we are just almost reaching the Nashik Road. Nashik Road is a toll highway, so it's a one side 110 rupees is a toll there. And in particularly in Nashik Road, you can see awesome greenery on both the sides. So we will be going through the Nashik Highway to near to Asangav, and then thereafter we will be taking a left for Manas Mandir. And as part of the unlock, you can see many of the hotels are all the hotels in the highway and restaurants in the highways have been opened. People are also traveling extensively, having travels, and people are having food, drinks from outside as well without having any fear. For having better or safety, as part of the safety measures, we have taken food with us. We thought it's better to have the food carrying, so we have taken food. And as part of, since again that it's a trip during the unlock time, we have taken all the safety measures to ensure that the protection is continued, and the so the chance of exposure of COVID will be lesser even if we are traveling. That's the kind of travel that we have planned. Please take care of these safety measures when you travel. So now we are closer to Asangav and we are taking the left. And after traveling a bit in the Asangav road, we have found a great place to have a video short break. So this is a place, and you can see awesome lush green. Now we are near to Shahpur, and we are on the way. In another 30 minutes, we will be reaching the Manas Mandir. You can see the board, the signboard of Manas Mandir. On the next left, we will be reaching Manas Mandir. But due to COVID, I believe if there would be some restrictions for the entry at Manas Mandir. This is the Manas Mandir. We have reached the Manas Mandir. Let's go and see whether this is open and public access is available or not. Unfortunately, due to COVID restrictions and the current tiring times, the Manas Mandir is not open for the public, so we will have to look at our next place. Once again, this is the fellow YouTuber, so we will have to look for our next destination, which is Jambe Dam. So the travel is showing some close to around 40-45 minutes from here, so let's go to Jambe Dam. So this is a wonderful scenery over here, so why we feel that since we have time, which we have got since the Manas Mandir is closed, let's spend some time over here. And people who are coming to Manas Mandir, it's en route Manas Mandir only, so people can spend some time. If you're with family, you can spend some time over here, enjoy the beauty of the nature, and then after that proceed to Manas Mandir or to Jambe Dam. So we are also planning like that only. We thought we'll just spend some time over here. There is some a waterfall kind of a place over there, so let's go and see how is that. it's a small stream, you know, it's passing through the road, but the view that it makes is awesome. So let me just go down and see how is the view. It feels like, you know, you are very close to a waterfall, Chota waterfall, and you know that the view gives awesome photography view. So we are proceeding to our next destination in our Hexa, and we are again going through the route. You know, the route is not so great. So now we are on the route to Jambe Dam. We hopefully feel that, you know, the dam, the reservoir side is open. You can see the road condition, it's not so great. Many of the places you cannot even call it as a road. So it is preferably, if you have a bigger vehicle, you experiment to reach Jambe Dam, because if you have a smaller car with lower ground clearance, it would be very difficult for you to reach there comfortably. And the map shows around 50 minutes from Manas Mandir to Jambe Dam. So we are again reaching Jambe Dam, and we have just parked the car over there, and it's a walkable distance from there. You can see the lush green and the village scene outside. Let's enjoy the beauty of the nature and let's walk to Jambe Dam. Since it's not a proper tourist destination, you can see the roads were not well maintained, and even the path is not a very explored thing. But obviously it's a good thing that, you know, less explored places is safer for us to travel in these times, and that's why we also thought this could be one of the best or a better destination for us right now. Since the Jambe Dam is not a tourist destination, the roads are not greatly maintained, which I have already explained to you, it was bad roads on the way. And again, you can see the trails as well. It's not a road which is leading us to be, which is leading us there. You can see the plastic waste or the food waste over here, which I really feel sad when I see that. People who are traveling, please do take care of the nature. Oh wow, what a great scene. Jambe Dam is just superb. I didn't expect that the dam would be this much bigger, or we can probably go this much near to the dam or reservoir, and I just loved it. And you know, it's quite safe for kids and family as well, because it's a spillover area, so the water flow will be restricted, and accordingly I think with family we will be able to enjoy if somebody is traveling over there. So let's enjoy the beauty of the dam. So let's do something creative, photography or videography. Next, what we can try out, I thought when I saw the waterfall, I thought, you know, we will record the ultra slow motion. So I'll explain you later in a separate video how the ultra slow motion is working and how do we take the ultra slow motion, which I will explain you. Let's record the ultra slow motion and some of the creative photography videography modes over here. So let's just go to the upper side of the dam so that we can see the reservoir, and let's see how the view from the top is available. Now we are on the top, and it's clearly written that it's closed. You can see the board, it says bandh. So, you know, obviously we don't want to venture, we don't want to deviate from any of the statutory or the government restrictions. So we are just returning, we just took some snaps from the top on the of the reservoir site, and we are just now returning to the car. You can see the dam side from the side. It's a you know, superb sight, I should say. So it's a superb sight. I was carrying the you know, DJI OM4 gimbal, so I thought, you know, let me try the gimbal as well. This shot what you're seeing is using the DJI OM4 gimbal. It's a very nice stabilizer for smartphones, and you can see I'm just you know, trying, I'm just running it with the gimbal, and you can see the stabilizing capacity of the gimbal. I'll be publishing a separate video on my hands-on you know, review and feature explanation of the gimbal. I've already posted one of the video with the basic features in the start. I'll be posting another detailed user review you know, after some time. Please do watch, please do wait for the same. So we have started from Jambe Dam. Our next destination is you know, Tansa Lake. So its map shows another 1 hour from Jambe Dam. So we are on the way to Tansa Dam now. So Tansa Dam is also having beautiful scenery en route. So we can actually enjoy a drive, we can enjoy the beauty when we are traveling to Shahpur area and or Asangav area. You can see on both sides, you see the paddy field. It's completely full of green. So somebody who is traveling from Mumbai city, or if you're traveling from other parts of the country, it's an awesome scenic view which is available on monsoon time or just after monsoon time. Now we are almost reaching the Tansa Lake. We have crossed the Adgaon, and you know, we are almost reaching to the Tansa Lake. You can see the awesome sightseeing en route. You feel that you are going through a forest. It's kind of a forest route to Tansa Lake. So we are going through the pipeline road, and I think we can do some creative videography tips and tricks. Let's see some hyperlapse and time lapse. We'll be explaining you how to shoot effectively a video using mobile in our Anybody Can Shoot series. Do watch. We'll be also telling you how to take photos. We will be having tutorials on how to take photos, how to edit videos from your mobile, and how to create awesome effects using mobile. Do watch our Anybody Can Edit and Anybody Can Shoot episode. Now again we are just going through the forest route. You can see the lush green outside. Let's enjoy the beauty and let's proceed. So we are almost reaching the Adgaon. Now you can see the village, typical village scenery, and let's enjoy it. Those who are coming from the city side, it would be great to enjoy the scenery and village sceneries and enjoy and have the feeling of the rural India. You can see the board. Now we are just leaving Adgaon, and we would be proceeding to Nashik Highway, and then we would be returning Kalyan. Even though we have planned three places today, but unfortunately due to the COVID situation and the tourism is not formally opened, we were unable to visit a couple of places. So Manas Mandir and Thansa Lake was not opened, and we could enjoy only at Jambe Dam. Anyway, so what we will do, we'll plan for next trip better, and hope for a better travel. Please do watch, like, subscribe News Mangalam. We will be coming up with more travel videos as soon as the travel is allowed and we are able to travel safely. Till then, it's bye from us. Thank you.